to popular demand, we're back with more English learning with the epic British rock band, Queen. In case you haven't seen the first lesson we did, I'll link it down in the description so that you can watch it later. Today, we're learning English with three of their greatest hits. But before we start, every single week we release lessons to help intermediate and advanced learners just like you to improve your English in a fun and dynamic way without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. So if you are new here, then make sure you join our community of over 5 million learners by hitting that subscribe button and the bell down below.
Pick my dues, time after time, after my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my share of standards in my bed, but I've got blue. I paid my dues, time after time.
To pay your dues means to go through many challenges and obstacles in your life and still come out of them successfully. In other words, to experience difficulties before achieving success.
I mean, this has been like my dream since I got my first Easy Bake Oven and opened Easy Monica's Bakery. I mean, I would kill for this job. I mean, I can totally do this job, and God knows I've paid my dues.
After my sentence, but committed no crime.
When a person is found guilty of a crime, he or she has to serve a sentence, which usually means going to jail for a certain amount of time as a punishment. If the person serves the sentence and is allowed to return to society as a free individual, we can say that this person has done his or her sentence. Freddie is obviously using this phrase figuratively here. He could mean that he had to face a lot of challenges and difficulties, even though he hadn't done anything wrong.
And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
The word mistake is a countable noun. Countable words are words that can be counted. A few means of small quantity. We use a few with countable nouns. Look at some examples. A few mistakes, a few books, a few cars, a few people, a few laptops. However, if the noun is uncountable, we use a little instead. A little milk, a little money, a little sugar, a little salt, a little time. But here's an advanced question for you. What is the difference between these sentences? I have a few friends, I have few friends. A few has a positive connotation. It means that even though you don't have a lot of something, you're still happy with the quantity. So if I say I have a few friends, I mean that I don't have a lot of friends, but I'm happy with the small number of friends I have. I have enough friends.
I love escorting people. In fact, a few years back, I put an ad in the paper starting an escort service. Got a lot of responses. Mostly creeps. Made a few friends.
On the other hand, few has a negative connotation. It means that you're not happy with the small quantity because it's not enough. So if I say, I have few friends, I mean that I'm not happy with it and I need more friends. Got it?
The 70s were not a good time for the city or for the department. Diaz or Santiago never would have made detective, and an openly gay man like me, I never would have been given a command. There were very few black detectives.
The same happens with a little and little. Look at these sentences. We have a little time to finish the project. We have little time to finish the project. Again, if I say, we have a little time, I mean that even though we don't have a lot of time, the time we have is still enough to finish the project. It has a positive connotation. But if I say, we have little time to finish the project, I mean that we don't have enough time, and we need more time to finish it. It's not enough.
But what's going on? I told you to pack the place.
Yeah, but I did the best I could. You gave me very little time.
By the way, we just created this lesson all about advanced quantifiers. So if you've ever confused few and a few, little and a little, so much and too much, or so many and too many, then I highly recommend you take your English from intermediate to advanced by watching that lesson next. You'll find it linked at the top and down in the description. I've had my share of sandwich in my bed. To have your share of something means to have more than enough of something, to the point that you don't want to have that anymore.
Oh, Monica's restaurant got a horrible review in the Post.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I didn't want her to see it, so I ran around the neighborhood and bought all the copies I could find.
Man, this is bad. And I've had my share of bad reviews.
To have sand kicked in your face means to be insulted by other people when people are mean to you. Freddie is saying that he had a lot of people being mean to him, and he doesn't want to experience that again. If you say, I've come through, you mean that you were able to experience difficulties and still remain strong, confident, and successful. A similar expression with through is to get through something, which means to experience a challenging or difficult situation and come out of it successfully.
Oh no, what is he doing here? All right, just keep playing. You'll get through this, you'll be fine. Okay, thank you.
It can be a huge challenge when learning a language to figure out which words and expressions are actually important and which ones you will never need. Without the guidance of a good teacher, you may waste a lot of precious time learning the wrong ones. But don't worry, because in our Fluent with Friends course, you can learn the words and expressions that natives actually use every single day. And you'll have a ton of fun doing it with the TV series Friends, which various academic studies show is the best TV series out there to learn English. In this course, you will also learn how natives reduce, cut, and connect sounds together, which is the secret to understanding us no matter how fast we speak. Plus, you'll learn to understand the cultural context so that you can laugh along with every joke. So you can give it a try right now for free with our 3-part masterclass. What are you waiting for? Just click up here or down in the description below now to sign up.
Love of my life, you've hurt me. You've broken my heart, and now you leave me. Love of my life, can't you see? Bring it back, don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me.
Aside from being a beautiful song, we can learn some connected speech with Love of My Life.
Love of my life, can't you see?
Notice how Freddie sings the words can't and you. This combination of T and Y usually takes on the sound ch, so we hear can't you. Check out this other Queen song called I Can't Live Without You. And notice how they sing the phrases without you and let you stay.
I can't live with you, but I can't. Don't know what it means to me.
In the phrase, take it away, we can hear the final T in it being pronounced as a flap T, which then connects to the word away. So we have take it away. Something similar happens in the phrase, what it means. Again, the final T in what is pronounced as a flap T, which then connects to the vowel I in it. Also, the final T in it is pronounced as a stop consonant, so we don't fully hear the T sound here. What it means.
I want to give the audience a song that they can perform, right? Let them be part of the band. So what can they do? Imagine thousands of people doing this in unison. Huh? Well,
what's the lyric?
Yeah. To conclude our lesson today, we're going to test your listening with one of Queen's most memorable songs, We Will Rock You. So first, you will listen to the verse, and you have to choose the best option, A, B, or C, that best fits each gap. Then you will listen one more time to check your answers. Ready?
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You big disgrace! Kicking your can all over the place, singing, we will rock you! We will rock you! Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. We will rock you. Sing it! We will rock you.
I pay my dues, time after time. After my sentence, but committed no crime.
In this context, to pay your dues means to experience difficulties and not become successful, to experience difficulties after achieving success, to experience difficulties before achieving success.
And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
The reason he's been frustrated is because he's been having moments to do personal things. Few, a few.
I've had my shell slammed into my breast.
To come through means to experience difficulties and still remain strong, to experience difficulties and feel powerless, to experience difficulties and give up.
At the end of the clip we were looking at, we can see another great connected speech example. Freddie doesn't say, at all, he says, at all. This is because often when we have a T between two vowel sounds, even of different words, it changes to a D sound. Listen to how I pronounce these examples. You're not hungry at all? I haven't heard from him at all today.